Hello, Flat Earth researchers, debaters, and debunkers. Being able to track the ISS, the International Space Station, or satellites and see them whizzing across the sky doesn't prove that we live on a globe. You might think it does because apparently they are doing it according to the laws of Newtonian physics, where things going fast enough and high enough above a spherical Earth will perpetually orbit the Earth as they attempt to fall down. So all you have to do really is go and look at the very first satellite that was put into orbit above the Earth by NASA and realize that this was a balloon and that nothing has actually changed since then. So let's see how it's possible to have a balloon going around and around above the level Earth, acting just as we see satellites behaving, and understand that there's nothing about Newtonian physics involved. It is simply these balloons being whizzed around in the winds above the level Earth. So it says here in this Britannica article, Echo, either of two experimental communications satellites launched into orbit around the Earth by the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, NASA, during the 1960s, consisting of aluminium-coated mylar balloons that were inflated after launching. The Echo satellites were passive instruments, i.e. they simply reflected radio waves back to Earth rather than actively receiving, amplifying, and transmitting them. Nevertheless, by proving the concept of relaying radio signals through space and by demonstrating the effectiveness of current satellite tracking and other ground station technologies, they stimulated a great deal of interest in the development of active satellite communication. So every mention of the word satellite here is talking about a balloon. Echo 1 launched on August the 12th, 1960, inflated to a diameter of 100 feet or 30 meters. The satellite was placed in an almost circular orbit at an altitude of approximately 1,000 miles or 1,600 kilometers. At this height, it circled Earth every 2 hours. The first transmissions reflected off its surface were conducted between a terminal built by Bell Laboratories in Holmdel, New Jersey, and another terminal built by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Goldstone, California. Echo 1 was used for experimental telephone data and facsimile transmissions. Signals were detected in Europe, although no messages were transmitted across the ocean. The satellite remained in orbit for almost 8 years and was visible as a rapidly moving star in the evening skies. All right, there you go. Seeing exactly the same thing with satellites these days. Echo 2, launched on January the 25th, 1964, was 135 feet, or about 40 meters in diameter. Its purpose largely was one of testing the dynamics of larger spacecraft, though it was also the focus of the first space venture involving cooperation between the USSR and the United States. A radio signal transmitted from the Jodrell Bank Observatory near Manchester, England, was reflected off Echo 2 and received at the Zemenki Observatory near Gorky, Russia, USSR, now Nizhny Novgorod, Russia. The satellite remained in orbit for 5 years. There you go. All right. Satellites always have been and always will be balloons whizzing around in orbits above the level Earth. As you can see on the right-hand side here, we've got an illustration of the Echo 1 orbit that is projected above an azimuth projection centered on the North Pole and an azimuth projection centered on the South Pole. It doesn't dictate or confirm the actual dimensions or shape or layout of the continents on the Earth. It is just an example to show you how these orbits, as it said in this article here, are circular orbits above the Earth, which last for several years at a time without the need for any propulsion or any need to go along with Newtonian physics. Thank you very much.